license. Woo! For the preacher to
Ashford.
And it reads, certificate of license. This is to certify Brenda Searcy, who has given evidence that God has called her into the gospel ministry, was licensed to preach the gospel as she may have opportunity and to exercise her gifts in the work of the ministry by Shiloh Baptist Church of Chester, Pennsylvania on the 6th day of September in the year 2017.
Right into the Word of God. There is a word in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 20, verses 14 through 17. And I'll be reading from the New Living Translation. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I come before you right now, Lord God, to say thank you. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad. Lord God, your daughter, I come before you and I ask you to decrease Brenda Searcy, and you increase in me now. Holy Spirit, you've already been welcome in the place. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you right now. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray with thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen.
The word is coming from 2 Chronicles, chapter 20, verses 14 through 17. Verse 14. The Spirit of the Lord came upon one of the men standing there. His name was Jehazel, son of Zechariah, son of Benaiah, son of Joel, son of Mattaniah, a Levite who was a descendant of Ashford. Verse 15, he said, listen, all you people of Judah and Jerusalem. Listen, King Jehoshaphat. This is what the Lord says. Do not be afraid. Don't be discouraged by this mighty army. For the battle is not yours, but God's.
Ah, yes.
Tomorrow, march out against them, and you will find them coming up through the ascent of Z. At the end of the valley that opens into the wilderness of Jeruel. Verse 17. But you will not need to fight.
Yes.
Take your position. Then stand still and watch the Lord's victory. He is with you. O people, Judah and Jerusalem, do not be afraid or discouraged. Go out against them tomorrow, for the Lord is with you. And I have to give a title today. The title is, But God. Amen, amen, amen. See, King Jehoshaphat was faced with a what would you do situation. Great TV show called What Would You Do? And in that TV show, there's hidden cameras. But one person is on camera thinking, well, they see something being done that's not right. They see a person might be being bullied. They might see a child being treated unfairly. What would you do? So that person has to make a decision in their mind if they're going to say something. If we think about him today, what are some of the unused situations that we face? What would you do if you received a phone call and your child was at the police station? What would you do if you received that unexpected layoff notice? What would you do if you find out your son or daughter is on drugs? What would you do? See, King Jehoshaphat was about to face a battle. See, the surrounding armies around him was ready to declare war on him. See, what happened with Jehoshaphat, he quickly was terrified. He was feared. He didn't know what to do. But immediately, he said, I got to seek the Lord. It's times in our lives, we got to go before the Lord and seek Him. We got to go before the Lord, humble our minds, and go before the Father and say, Lord, I need you right now. I can't handle this battle right now, but I need you to fight for me. But God, but God, but God. So he sought the Lord. The next thing King Jehoshaphat did, he proclaimed a fast. So just like everybody that's sitting here in this sanctuary went on a fast. They corporately went on a fast. When you go on a fast, you're abstaining from food. So when you're abstaining from food, you're getting all that junk out of our system. Yeah. Amen. So that's when God is allowed to come into us, allowing us to decrease and Him to even more increase in us. Because we're trying to eliminate some of those toxins that's in our body. He proclaimed a fast. He abstained from food. But some of the things that we can abstain from today is, I think about how we might binge watch some of these TV shows, amen. Sometimes we might binge watch Game of Thrones. Sometimes we might binge watch Power. But see, during that time when we're binge watching, that is time where we can be putting the Word of God in us, amen. We need the Word of God. So as we're putting that Word in us, we're praying, we're fasting. And always remember, with fasting is always accompanied with prayer. There's prayer, there's fasting, and there's praying. It goes together. And always remember too, we all can pray. That's just something that we all can do. But when it comes to fasting, we have to accompany that with prayer. And that's what he did. What did he do so far? King Jehoshaphat, he sought the Lord. What else did he do? He proclaimed a fast. And what another thing that he did, he went into prayer. He went into prayer. When you look at verse 6, he says, O Lord, God of our ancestors, you alone are the God who is in heaven. He's describing God who he is. See, when we can do this when we have a relationship with him. Amen. So he's describing God. He's saying, you are ruler of all the kingdom of the earth. You are powerful and mighty, and no one can stand against you. So see, that's when we have to make the thing personal. And that's what King Jehoshaphat did. He made it personal because he knew he couldn't do this thing by himself. So as we get to our text, remember the text in verse 14. See, there was someone there watching. There was someone there observing everything that was going on. And his name was Jehazel. And see, Jehazel received the word from the Lord. And as he received that word from the Lord, he said, the battle is not yours, it's yours. He spoke that thing to King Jehoshaphat. And as he spoke it to King Jehoshaphat, it was for everybody that was there. So when that word was spoken to King Jehoshaphat, it was a shift. It was a shift on how he felt about what was about to happen with his battle. So because that one word changed how the battle was going to be positioned. Amen, amen. So as we look down into the text, so we already know, what did he do so far? He sought the Lord. What else did he do? He proclaimed some things. What else did he do? He prayed. So now it's time for battle. But see, this is a different type of battle. The position of the battle is different. See, King Jehoshaphat, the next day, he ordered his praise and worship team to go before the army. Yeah. Jesus can't heal. There's no hurt he cannot heal. All things work according to the Master's purpose and his holy will. No matter what you are going through, remember, God is using you. For this battle is not yours, it's the Lord. There is no sadness that Jesus can't feel. And there is no sorrow that he can't heal. For all things work according to the Master's purpose and his holy will. Hold your head up high. Don't you cry. It's the Lord. Remember, this battle is not yours, but God. God bless.
Preach to us tonight.
Yeah.
And never forget this, as a preacher,
You preach to yourself first before you preach to everybody else. And so the same way that you told us tonight that the battle is not ours, it's the Lord's. When hell turns up the heat, when you find yourself wondering, what did I do to find myself in this situation?
Come on, preacher.
Remind yourself of the word that you preached on tonight. Yes. And sometimes you got to look in the mirror and say, Brenda, the battle's not yours, it's the Lord's. The battle's not yours, it's the Lord's. Tell yourself, I'm in one of those difficult situations, but the battle's not yours, it's the Lord's. One of the things that I foolishly prayed, and I say I foolishly prayed it, I'll be honest with you, before I preached my initial sermon, I said to the Lord, I said, Lord, you know, I said, Lord, put me through everything that I'm going to preach first so I can be confident in the word and then test it again afterwards. Yeah, I'm actually foolishly praying. But I say that because there are going to be times in which the devil will test the strength of your word, the strength of your conviction, and the strength of your faith. But if you really truly believe the word that you preached on tonight, you will never doubt yourself. You would never doubt your God, and you would never doubt your ministry, because as you told us tonight, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's.
Amen.
I just want to let you know, I'm extremely proud of you, and I'm looking forward to even bigger and better things that God is going to do for you in your life, and all the people that are going to be saved because of your ministry. Now, there's one more thing I need to give you. Remember, as a preacher, what we preach from is the Word of God. But even beyond being what we preach from being the Word of God, the Bible says, how can a young man and a young woman keep him or herself pure? And the answer is, that word have I hidden in my heart,
that I might not sin against you.
This Bible that you're going to receive is one that you can read and study from. That will help you grow. But there are going to be moments in which you don't have a physical Bible with you. I know in this age, day, and technology, you say, well, I can pull out my phone. But you may not even have your phone with you. And when you're in one of those what would you do situations that you preached us tonight, you need to be able to pull the word of God out of your heart. It's got to be what you live, what you breathe, what you eat. You need to let this guide you daily. Don't pick it up. Remember, I told you, we don't read our Bibles to preach the word. We preach out of our overflow with God. And so if you find yourself getting to the point where the only time you pick up your Bible is to preach, you need to recalibrate and rediscipline yourself.
That's good.
We preach out of the overflow, but we use the word of God to guide us daily and to tell us more and more of who God is. So I'm going to give this to you. Keep God's word hidden in your heart. Study it. Allow yourself to dive into God's word often. As a matter of fact, let it be like salt water. We read the book, Ethics 101, and there's a line in there that says that, I'll invert it slightly. Let the word of God be like salt water, where the more you drink it, the thirstier you become for it. Never allow your thirst to be quenched. Always have a hunger and a desire for the word. And there's no telling where God will take you when you stay faithful and committed to Him. You despise the one tonight as well. And I'm going to go ahead and take my seat and turn the service on over to Minister Brenda Searcy as she comes to give her remarks and her acknowledgments on tonight.
It would just take so long to just acknowledge everyone.
first, I just give honor to God.
Amen.
Because of God, I'm here.
Come on,
yeah. Come on. Dr. Millsaps can attest to this. I've been running from this for over 20 years.
Yeah.
Jesus.
And I just couldn't do it anymore. I had to be obedient.
Yes.
And that's what I tell my children, to be obedient. So, Dr. Millsaps, thank you.
Amen.
This makes a lot about you. I'm just so grateful. I'm just so grateful. First, I want to say something to my husband. May of next year, 20 years of marriage. And as I think about him, I think about what God produced through us. My oldest son, stand up, Jawan Lamar Douglas. Our baby boy, he is at Delaware State University, so you might look at that. And our baby girl, Jada Searcy. So grateful for my children. I have to acknowledge two special people. I would be here because of them. So I have to introduce my mother. And I have to introduce my daddy. And because of them, one thing that I always tell my children is to honor your parents. And because of them, I can sit here today.
Come on now.
When you have good parents,
amen.
My sisters and I, we have good parents. Not even good parents, great parents, excellent parents. And sometimes it's like a running joke when we always say, we've been raised right. But when we really sit down and think about it, we've been raised right. But I thank God for them. Miss Peggy, I thank you for being here too. Thank you. But it's just amazing what God has done. I want to acknowledge maybe three more people. My aunt is here, and she is 92 years old. And this lady is a special lady in my life. This is my father-in-law's sister. And every time I tell her, they'll speak about my marriage, they always say, well, Brenda, this was your aunt. No, this is Darnell's aunt, but we're together. We're
Amen.
One. She's
mine. Right.
Amen. So I just love her wisdom. Amen. Her wisdom alone is why I'm standing here today, too. I thank God for my sisters. And I have some other sisters that are here, and I want y'all to stand. I'm looking at y'all. My Warren family sisters, can y'all stand, please? These are my college friends. Over 20 years. Penny and I went to college together, and once we became friends, we became family. So I thank God for them. I thank God for a co-worker. It's nothing like going to work and you can praise the Lord with somebody. So, Miss Ellie, can you please stand? This is my friend, Warren Penny. Thank God for you. Don't want to miss anybody but Shiloh Baptist Church.
Amen.
I love y'all.
Love you.
Yes, I'm there. Deaconess Ministry, thank you. Thank you for the prayers. Thank you for showing me how it really is. I do pray that it's so valuable to me, and I say thank you to all of you. If your name starts with the letter A, Z.
Amen. There you go.
That includes everybody. And I'm stealing that from somebody. So I just want to say thank you all. I do. I thank you all. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm sorry, I forgot one thing. to the team, our team, Lisa Hollis. Lisa Hollis, come with her. We've been on this road for about a year plus. And I tell you, it's so funny how God makes a 360. Lisa Hollis and I, we graduated from high school together.
All right.
And to know that we're walking into ministry together,
Amen.
Nobody but God. I just thank God for you too. Can't wait to hear you guys next week coming up. But I just thank God. And then to our pastor. Wow. Pastor Ashford, one of the words that still keeps ringing in my ear is do not be weary. And well done.
Hallelujah.
Do not be weary. I just think about the time that he put in with his students. It was valuable time. And I appreciate that. So I thank you, and may God continue to encourage you in this walk, and to know that the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's.
Yeah.